I'm Travis Ishida, and we are here at the 2015 Precision Rifle Series in Tehachapi, California. Witness the nation's top long-distance shooters battle it out in this year's season finale. The PRS started out as a grassroots competition and has now grown into a full-blown nationwide championship event. With over 104 competitors, there is not only a point race for series champion, but several other categories such as top ladies, top senior, and top law enforcement. With over $50,000 in cash and prizes on the table, we wish all of our 2015 championship finale competitors the best of luck. This is the Precision Rifle Series.
Good morning and welcome to stage one of the Precision Rifle Series in Tehachapi, California. This counts for 10 possible points with 90 second time limit. Each shooter has to engage 5 targets near to far from the right side of the tree, right shoulder, and then another 5 targets left side of the tree, left shoulder. We're here with squad 1, which consists of 10 of the top shooters in the PRS that are currently leading this finale. Let's see how it goes.
Impact!
Yeah, I just took my dope and took the pins off to the ankle.
Impact!
Alright, Jake, you just got off your first stage. You shot, what, 9 for 10?
9 for 10, yeah. It was a fun stage. You had to shoot weak hand, you had to shoot strong hand. Kind of mixes things up a little bit. The wind's a little tricky out there. It's going a little bit left to right now, but sometimes it calms down and hits right to left, so it's fun.
9 for 10 is a great start. Yeah. It seems like everybody so far is shooting really solid first thing in the morning.
Yeah.
So how do you feel this first half of the day is going to go?
Well, you know, this is, you know, we got 10 of the best shooters in the country in this squad. So it's going to be a fun day all day today. I expect all these guys to shoot 9 out of 10 or 10 out of 10 on every single stage. So, you know, you just got to kind of keep it up and hope everything runs smooth all day.
Impact.
And the one that I missed, I caught a heartbeat and broke a bad shot.
Impact!
Is this number 5?
No, 4. Impact!
Possibility of 12 points, there's 4 targets and 120 second time limit. From position 1, shooters will engage each target with 1 round each. They'll move to position 2 and then move to position 3.
A little tough, wind switching up, just very challenging on the heel side, having to go from, you know, from a bipod position, you know, raise your bipods up and stuff like that, and just pretty challenging. Wind's tricky. It's fun.
A lot of fun. It looks like you're having a good time out there, even though, you know, you had some difficult positions to be shooting from. 3 different positions in this stage. too prone, it looked like, and then one just kind of however you can get comfortable.
Yeah, it's fast and furious. I got all my rounds off except for one. So other than that, I mean, just the wind switching up pretty good, and just trying to make your hits when you can, you know.
Combination of angles, distance, wind, it's going to be an interesting one. Just making sure nothing else rolls down the hill. So.
Yeah, we definitely don't want to lose
long
anything.
Drop, yep.
Long drop. Now, how are you feeling overall for the day?
So far, we're on stage two of the match. We're just looking towards a great weekend and just give it all that we have. And I think it's a great facility, a great course of fire, and it's up to us to do the job right.
All right, Matt, so you just ran that stage. How'd it feel?
Well, I guess there's something between this stage and last stage when I was shooting, had my barrel on the tree down there, so about a mil off. Took me about 3 or 4 shots to figure it out, so I changed my dope on the fly and ran it and did the best I could.
Oh, you definitely hustled. You put a lot of effort forth in it, and it looked like you had a little bit of struggles. The first position, second position, you made up some shots.
Yeah.
And then the third position, you were trying to get comfortable. I mean, that's a steep hill.
Yeah, it is. It's kind of you never know until you're actually down there ready to shoot it before you actually can guesstimate how difficult it's really going to be, what it's going to take to get in position comfortably. But it's just it's a pretty steep hill.
Awesome. Well, we'll let you get going, and we appreciate it. We'll see you soon.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
All right, guys, we're coming to you from the Precision Rifle Series. I'm here with my partner, Matt, and we're gonna go over some of the issues that some long range shooters face when cleaning and maintaining their products.
Our solvent, it doesn't have any effect on metal. It's a carbon solvent. It pulls the copper out once it's not attached by the carbon anymore.
Focusing on one of the products that we make specifically for these types of applications, this is our Lock-U Long Gun Operator's Cleaning Kit, Universal. What you're gonna see here in the back is the stainless steel cleaning rods that we have for the kit. Mil-spec brush, our basic technology, which is our, like Matt said, our neutral solvent. It's a pH neutral product, so it's not gonna damage anything. Our oil goes from -90 to 410, and our grease. A lot of folks love using this for their bolts or raceways. And if you guys wanna find out more, please go to breakthroughclean.com.
I'm George Gardner with Team Bushtail Tactical. We're the premier sponsor of the PRS and the PRS Final. I'd like to talk about a new product that Bushnell's coming out with. It's a play on the original DMR scope that's been so popular. They're gonna come out with a new version called the DMR2. It's gonna have a low profile 10 mil knob with a zero stop and a low profile windage knob. The scope is gonna have those features and will still come out at the same retail price as the original DMR. So it's gonna be really nice, and Bushnell's really excited about it.
Team Bushnell would like to congratulate all the 2015 competitors that made it out here today. It's a true honor to shoot with you all. In addition, we'd like to thank everybody that's going to make it out in 2016, and we look forward to meeting all the new shooters. If you'd like to find more information about the new scopes and new products coming out, visit bushnell.com.
Hi, I'm Eric Stecker, president of Burger Bullets and ABM Ammo. We're here with Precision Rifle Series. It's a fantastic rifle competition that we're thrilled to be involved in. You know, Burger Bullets is coming out with some exciting new products. We've been evolving over time, and the idea of being associated with such a high-class operation as the PRS shooting series and the national championships is a thrill for us. We have a lot of things going on that are going to be coming out in the future, including some ammunition that we're making as part of our extended brand at ABM Ammo. And so if you want to learn more about us, go to our website at burgerbullets.com or abmammo.com. Thank you and congratulations to the PRS shooters.
Upon the start signal, engage each target with two rounds. Shooters must use the log for support for each shot fired. There's a possibility of 8 points with four targets and a total of 90 seconds.
A log with a bag, is that all right?
As long as no. If you're using a bipod, it's gotta be on this log, okay? We got a 30 second prep time for each one, and this is a 90 second course. Any questions?
Where are the targets?
Oh, just, okay, off this first finger right here, we have one, and they're all green.
I'm going to put my long.
Impact.
We got Jim, Aaron.
What's that?
Stand by.
Held 1.4 for wind on the first target, and I seen my miss, got a good correction, and I, as fast as I could, I just run out, I came back, hit 1, 2, 3, and the little one at 4, and I mean, you can't really ask for much better than that. 6 inches at 960 is a pretty tight target to hit, and I felt like I was lucky in that wind.
No, I don't think that was luck. I think you definitely performed very well for it. Now, we have a very tight group here. I mean, we have the top 10 in your squad one. We have the bottom 10 of the top 20 in squad 2. Who do you think is your stiffest competition here?
Oh, I think Dave Preston can shoot solid at any range in the country. Jeremy Bentham, he's always in the running. He's always in the hunt. I mean, he gets a lot of top 3 finishes. Jake Vibbert is a wild card. He can come in here and just clean house, or he might just have an off day. Joe Wald shot solid this year. So, I mean, it's anyone's guess right now.
Stage 5. Under and over. With a possibility of 8 points, 4 targets, and a 90-second time limit, each shooter must start at the port arms and hold or handle all of their equipment. Upon the start signal, the shooter will engage 4 targets with 1 round each, either from under or over the barrier. After that, they can safely move to their second firing position, which is going to be the opposite of where they started. Re-engage those 4 targets for 1 round each.
We're here at the 2015 PRS Championships at the finale, and Jay Allen, this is actually Lisa with Jay Allen Enterprises. They make a phenomenal chassis. What are your hopes for Jay Allen in the PRS?
Just trying to get more awareness out there about our product and help support the guys, you know, shooting. It's just fun because we just started getting into this, and it's really fun to get out there and also see what they like about our product and what they want to see as improvements or other options that they can use to help them at the different stages.
Hey guys, welcome to the 2015 PRS finale here in Tehachapi, California. Right now we are on stage 9 on the second half of day 1. We have the third shooting team up on coming up on deck here. This stage is called They Are Out There. It's 3 targets at just over 1,000 yards. It's a very tricky stage for a total of 9 points. So far, we've only seen a total of 7 points accomplished due to heavy winds and changing wind conditions. Because we're out over past 1,000 yards and the terrain behind us, winds are getting pushed left to right, right to left, and everywhere in between. Stay tuned. All right, Justin, you just got done with the stage. How'd you do?
I got 5 hits on it. The wind was pretty switchy, but once you kind of figured it out, it was held up pretty good. Tough stage, long targets with the wind like it is. It's pretty tough.
Absolutely. Now I noticed out of everybody here, you have probably one of the most vibrant platforms out here.
Yeah.
What are you shooting for us today?
That stock is a J. Allen stock, Surgeon rifle, built by Perry Custom Gun, 6.5-47. They told me they wanted to put one together with whatever color I wanted, so I was like, let's go bright.
So Lisa and them made it happen for you.
Oh, yeah. It's easy to find on the line, that's for sure.
Absolutely. No one's going to go home with that one on mistake.
No, not at all.
Good run, Justin.
All right, Solomon, you just shot this round. How'd you do?
It's pretty hard. The wind's moving up and down, so having to change the target left to right, and it's really tough.
Now, you had some wind calls initially planned out before you stepped up to the plate. What happened there?
I had my calculator adjusted to 4 mils of lead, so the guys were giving me a hard time on that. But awesome. It made out. It was good.
Steve, start. You're next. Dorgan, you're in the hole.
Solomon. The stage that you're at right now, we've heard that there's been some good impacts and some low impacts, but nobody's done better than 7 so far. What are your predictions for your performance coming up here?
Well, I'll tell you what, when I'm about to shoot, the wind's going to blow exactly at 10 miles an hour. This is what's going to happen, all right. I'm telling you right now. I'm going to hold 10 mile an hour wind, and it's going to all, push right into the target. No 11, no 12, no 6, 10.
Perfect. We're going to hold you to that. We're going to be watching closely.
Ready. Very good. Thank you.
It wasn't 10.
All right, Ty, so you just wrapped up your shooting at this stage here. How'd you do?
Not very good. I got 2 out of 9. It's just crazy how it goes. You're holding for, my guess was 10, like I said, to begin with, and then it appeared to be 8. Held 8, and then it went 11. Moved to the next target, and then all those things again, it's just constantly changing. You do the best you can and try not to let any one stage get you down, and smile and have a good time and enjoy your friends and enjoy the shoot.
There's paint still on them, I'm sure of that.
Glass. After the 5 minutes is up, you will not be on glass, binos, spotters, anything.
You have to go left to right.
All right, guys, we're here at stage 9. These are some of our awesome ROs, making sure that this match is safe and goes smoothly. So can you guys introduce yourself for us?
Sure. Rich Cronister.
Nathan Webnar.
James Jeffries.
Oscar Milanis.
All right, guys. So, from what I understand, nobody has a perfect perfect round on this stage so far.
Correct.
Not so far.
So, why is this stage so difficult?
Tricky wind.
Shooting over a canyon, and it's different wind calls, shifty winds.
Yeah. Winds going back they're just forth, chasing the wind all over.
There's wind here, there's wind there, and there's some kind of weird wind in the middle. Who knows?
So what is the best score we've seen so far today?
There was a phenomenal shooter named Dorgan, I think his name. Dorgan or something. That guy killed it.
That guy's
probably like seven.
We've got 3
seven
people
is the
that
highest
scored
score
seven.
Out of 9 hits possible.
7 out of 9.
7 out of 9 is the highest score so far.
So, well, on behalf of everybody at the PRS, we want to thank you guys for all your hard work being out here, donating your time to make sure that everyone runs safe, smooth, and it's a great time.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Honor up.
Pleasure.
All right, shooter ready.
You ready?
Stand by. Impact! Impact!
Oh, fuck, I
did. Ah!
Just underneath it on that last.
Hey, still kicking ass, Jake. Nice shooting, man.
Right.
Very nice.
Hey. Was it
Good?
You need a hug? Huh?
Oh, must have been good.
And I'm here with Mr. Rick Reeves. How are you today, sir?
Good.
Terrific. How do you think you're performing so far against this tough competition?
Everyone else is cracking the scores, maybe top five, top ten. We'll see.
Awesome. Now, tell us a bit about the PRS. How long have you been involved?
I shot the first PRS match that they hosted in Frost, Texas in December 2011.
Terrific. And you've been following the series ever since?
Ever since.
That's terrific. Yep. Now, start of the match in the top 20. We're going to break that top 10.
Hopefully. We'll know in the morning.
Yep. Well, we're absolutely thrilled that you're here with us today, and we look forward to following you through the rest of the match and wish you the best of luck, sir.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Hi, my name is Jake with JC Steel Targets. We're here in sunny California in Tehachapi for the Precision Rifle Series Championship. JC Steel Targets is once again a sponsor. We're really happy to be here, really excited to be here. We got some awesome products for all the shooters on the prize table. And one product we want to show is our 45% IPSC spring T-post target. Super loud, great ring. We're really excited about it, and a lot of the shooters are excited about it. We just want to say thanks for all the shooters, all their support. You can find all of our products at jcsteeltargets.com.
Hi, I'm Scott McCree of McCree's Precision. I brought a couple of our products with us today. One of them is our drop-in do-it-yourself chassis upgrade system. Has multiple adjustments on the rear, length of pull, butt pad height, cheek pieces up and down. It also can be purchased as a folder for making your rifle more compact. This particular model also includes our embedded anti-cant level called an MLEV. All of our systems are an instant conversion to detachable magazine and don't require any gunsmithing. So if you're getting into the PRS circuit or you're just a discriminating shooter, this is a very good option for you to consider. One of the other products I brought with me is our new BR10 rifle system. This system also has adjustable rear components, folding, embedded anti-cant level system, a proprietary 4-in tube and barrel system, and these systems are guaranteed sub-half. With good hand loads, you can achieve a .1. All of us at McCree's Precision wish to congratulate every one of the competitors that worked so hard this season to get to the 2015 finale. And we also wish you the best of luck in 2016. You can reach us at www.mccreesprecision.net.
Proof barrels are the best in the industry because we are increasing the safety and the effectiveness of today's warfighter and peacekeeper through reducing weight and increasing the accuracy of their firearms.
So with a Proof Research shooting team, we brought together some really great shooters, some of the best shooters in the country, to try to give us a chance to prove that the Proof product not only works, but also disprove some of the things that are inaccurate about particularly carbon fiber barrel.
I've been shooting the Proof barrels for quite some time. I was with them just at the very beginning and seeing them developed through the years. I've gotten some products that a lot of people may never see to test during the development. They never quit trying to make a better product in every aspect of building the barrels.
For more information on Proof Research products, go to proofresearch.com. I'll see you at the range.
Here we are at the end of day one on stage 10, over the edge. With a possibility of 8 points, there's 4 targets and a 90-second timer. Upon the start of the signal, shooters will engage each target with 2 rounds.
I would have been right about the 5:30. Heck, I'm getting out after the delay.
Closest to farthest, 2 rounds at each target. 90 seconds. Any questions?
We're here at the end of day one with Dave and Joe. How'd you guys do today?
Go ahead, Dave.
I shot solid.
Dropped a few points here and there. Didn't have any terrible stages, but didn't have any great stages. So I think I performed about average.
I was definitely below average today. Had a little, you know, higher expectations than how I performed. Had some really good stages, some really poor stages. Had a lot of fun. I just enjoy trying to keep up with him.
This wind out here, even right now, it's ridiculous to be shooting in some of these stages, but that's what makes it challenging.
It's changing for every shooter, so you can't go off what somebody else did before you. You're basically starting from scratch every time you get up there.
Hey guys, we are here with Kevin. He is kind of our wild card. This is your first championship match, and you are in the top 10 at the 2015 PRS finale. Have you had any help along the way, sponsors, things of that nature?
I recently got hooked up with Vortex. I'd been shooting their stuff, and I think they were just proud of how I was doing, and just mainly kind of putting my own stuff together. And the AI team's been really helpful, kind of pointing out some things to work on and just good advice along the way. And Joe Walls and everybody at OTM have been great.
That's awesome. Yeah, this sport is definitely, it's very unique because of the camaraderie and everybody willing to help each other out.
Yeah.
So that's absolutely phenomenal.
It's been great. You won't find another person out here who, you know, tries to give you a bad call, tries to, you know, game you or anything like that. Everybody wants to help. Everybody wants you to shoot well, and it's great.
One mil, left edge with 1 mil dowel on.
One, huh?
Yep. Let's go, Johnny.
This stage here was great. Shooting way down the canyon, way down the ravine. Just an awesome view from up here. You know, the biggest thing for me is the targets are starting to get washed out because of the shade and the sun. You're kind of looking into the sun. It's just a different atmosphere up here compared to what we were shooting this morning.
Now, what are we going to do different for tomorrow?
You know, I got to find my targets a little better. I'm used
really?
To some grasslands and stuff, and so I got to try to find my targets a little better and find them a little quicker, and hopefully I can get more points.
Guys came across.
Yeah.
Right there, just to the right of it.
So I have to ask, which stage would you like to do over?
The long range one over there.
You know, a lot of people are having issues on that range. There's a lot of tricky wind.
Yeah, there was. I made the same hold. Bullet one kept, made a correction, went in the same spot. And what can you do?
Yeah, you know, it's just the luck of the draw.
Yeah,
sure.
It is.
Damn it.
That wind let up on them two, Jeremy?
Yep. Sure did.
Center and right edge works on the first two, though, huh?
Yeah.
We've had our first reshoot for the day. Can you kind of explain what's happened for our viewers?
This is the only stage in the entire match. We accidentally have a target that's in view, same exact size target as the other two targets. In this case, we have a shooter that accidentally engaged the wrong target. Because that target's in play, all four of the ROs said that because the target's visible, you can easily come up on it. And the shooter and somebody else on the squad both said that they did not get in the brief that target was out of play. As of right now, we awarded the shooter a reshoot. We made a call. I'm the range master on this side. The four ROs, we all agreed with the call. It will be discussed higher up with the match director. And we have scores from the pre and the post. And we can make a call together once we get back.
The first ones are coming off right now. They're coming off rare to medium. After that, you get what you get. So, let's see.
We appreciate you guys doing this.
Just came up grabbing it right there.
We are here at the end of day one of the 2015 Precision Rifle Series Championships in Tehachapi, California. We just wrapped dinner, a phenomenal steak dinner cooked by cowboys on this cattle ranch, and it was absolutely phenomenal. We had a surgeon up here giving away some awesome prizes. We had Jay Allen up here giving away an awesome prize to our ROs, showing love and support to everybody involved, as well as SAC giving out a McMillan, giving out suppressors, all kinds of great stuff, and this is just the first night. All right, Rich, how do you think the match went?
Went off without a hitch. You know, they were out there, they were switching five stages over here, five stages on another mountain over there. Flowed pretty good, so you're managing 104 shooters around the course all day. The shooters that I got to see shoot, what an awesome experience to see them out on the stages, shooting off of rocks and logs and cross canyon. A lot of switchy winds, so that gets a lot of shooters. You can't see the mirage. Sometimes you're busy in the scope looking at things, and the wind will switch on you, so you don't pick it up until you see that cloud of dust, and then you got to do
something. If you see that cloud of dust.
then you got to do something different. From what I've heard, the scores are tight.
That's what I saw.
Top guy around 60 points or so, a little over. So, you know, maybe 120 to win the match or something like that. We'll see what it comes out to be.
So if you were a betting man, who would you put your money on?
I've heard that our senior shooter, Rick Reeves, is in the lead. He recently won the heat stroke open.
Yes.
And when he's on fire, he's unstoppable.
He is absolutely phenomenal. I had a chance to speak with him earlier today, and just a totally humble guy, phenomenal shooter. So that means if he takes the overall, he could take possibly two divisions for himself.
Right, so he'll win senior. Of course, winning the match is the ultimate prize, to win the finale.
Absolutely.
It's a long day. It's a full another day of points, so anything can happen, though.
Absolutely. Well, we appreciate your time. You guys put on a phenomenal match, and we look forward to seeing you in the morning.
Thank you, Contingency X, for being here. We appreciate it.
Our pleasure.
All right. All right.
Tomorrow, we're going to be out here again, bright and early, doing it all over. We have another 10 stages of difficult shooting that's going to be absolutely phenomenal. We're throwing in a couple of different obstacles in there that's going to make it even more exciting. So make sure to stay tuned, and we'll see you in the morning.
Hi, I'm Lisa, and this is Tony, and we're from J. Allen Enterprises, and we're at the PRS finale in Tehachapi. And we make the J700, Remington 700 stock. Some of the features on our stock, our recoil pad here, it's a rubber butt pad, but it's not just mushy, it really absorbs the recoil. You can purchase butt spacers if you need to make it. Any length of pull you need to make it, you can get there with our spacers. Our offhand rest has a built-in Picatinny rail, so you can attach a monopod. We're just starting to get involved in the PRS. It's really neat to see the guys out here shooting our product and find out what they like about it and where we can make improvements also. For purchases, you can order through Third Generation Shooting Supply if you want like a standard color. If you want something special, then you can order directly through us. You go to jae700.com. We would like to congratulate the PRS competitors that made it out here. They worked real hard all year.
Hey guys, this is Brian. I'm here with US Optics. We are a high-end optics manufacturer. We've been around for 25 years. We are based out of Brea, California. Our roots started being a custom optics manufacturer, and now we offer a commercial off-the-shelf line of optics. We basically take our most common optics that our customers requested when we were a custom shop, and now put that in an off-the-shelf product that our normal dealers can actually carry out there in the marketplace. So from all of us at US Optics, we want to congratulate this year's PRS finale winners. We definitely want to wish you guys good luck for the next year. You guys can visit us at US Optics at usoptics.com. We're also on Instagram and Facebook, so definitely check us out.
We are here at day two of the 2015 Precision Rifle Series Championships, and we are here with Sydney and Melissa, who just shot one of our funner stages, and both of them had a little bit of excitement going on.
A lot of people were trying to come up with equipment, and I usually keep it simple, stupid, works better for me. So run up, standing, 5 seconds left to clean it, and I had a mag with too many rounds, and I couldn't get that last round fed in with 5 seconds. So close.
So close. We saw a little bit of disappointment in your face when you chamber that round.
No. I couldn't get it, and it was breaking my heart. Just breaking it.
How about you, Melissa? You had a very interesting match, something that we don't see very often, but, you know, we're human.
I had a game plan. I got up there, executed the first target,
ran to my second one. I have been doing well using holdovers, and I guess when I manipulated my bolt back, I hit safety without knowing and started panicking when the trigger wouldn't, I mean, it would, the gun would not go off, so.
Yeah, we all thought you had a mechanical malfunction.
I thought so too. That was the first thing that went through my mind.
I noticed a lot of camaraderie between you two girls here. How long have you guys been shooting matches together?
About 2 years we've been together. She actually was watching me in my very first match that I ever shot. We always help each other out any way we can. We're ladies. We stick together.
So you guys are moving on. You still have 8 stages left in the day, which means that you had your bad stage for the day. So we're done with that. So we're going to see nothing but stellar performance from you the rest of the day.
Absolutely stellar.
And you're kicking ass, so don't have a bad stage.
Yeah. I hope I don't have any bad stages. If I can keep it up like that, maybe I could get the last shot and clean one or two.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely. No, you girls are doing phenomenal. We know there's only a small handful of you that are in this finale this year, but hopefully next year you'll have a little more girl power here.
A little bit more. Yep.
We are here with Match Director Mike Voigt. Mike, how are you, sir?
I'm good. Terrific. A little short on sleep, but that's all good.
You know, that's how it always is with these matches.
It's a big honcho job.
We are at, so you think you want to be a cowboy, do you?
Oh, absolutely. We always want to show that this is a working cattle ranch, so we've got them up on a horse. Today, there's a lot of shorter range stuff. Part of it is so we can kind of run through here and get our match over with earlier and get our awards done and all of that. But you got to interject some fun, so
absolutely.
When they're ready, squeeze the ear and listen to the thing gallop around and whinny at you. Appreciate you guys coming out, doing an awesome job with
our
us.
Our pleasure. Thanks for having us.
All right.
Take care.
Plus it matches your rifle.
Gunmetal. It's glitter, too, for good luck.
You shot very well. You got over to the barricade, to the fence there. And again, you shot very well. It looks like you were kind of on your tippy toes on that first shot, though.
I was, just so I can be safe and make sure I hit my target. Yeah, it was a little bit tall for me.
That's awesome. It's definitely more of your element now that the safety's working.
Yes.
You're rocking it. Does this bring back the confidence moving forward into other stages?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. When you're able to hit the targets and, like I said, you know your rifle's working, right? You've got your confidence in your rifle and your scope. I mean, yeah, you feel good moving forward.
We are here with Regina Milkovich, who is our top contender coming in first place in the women's division, correct?
Yes, sir.
And you just dominated the stage.
Thanks.
You did great, some awesome shooting. Now, you have a couple of other female competitors that are kind of chomping at your heels here.
Mm-hmm.
Is there any kind of strategy or game plan for you to make sure that you stay in that number one spot?
No, actually, I prefer to help them out so they shoot better. So, no game plan, just have fun.
Have fun,
be safe.
How long have you been shooting PRS or long range?
PRS since the beginning. I've been shooting long range for about 5 years.
Terrific. So. And you're not out here by yourself. You're kind of a dynamic duo. You got your husband out here kicking some butt too.
Yes, sir. Yeah. He shot really well yesterday, so he's been pretty consistent all year long. I'm really proud of him.
Absolutely, and I'm sure he's very proud of you as well.
Yes.
Hey shooters, I'm Scott Satterley from Core Shooting Solutions.
I'm Jeremy Bentham from Portland, Oregon.
All right, today we're talking about Defiance Machine.
A little bit about Defiance and more importantly, the people that work there is my first match rifle that I ever built was on one of their actions and it got stolen from me 2 weeks after it was built. I called up Defiance, I explained them the situation, asked how long they were out, and they told me 6 months. An action showed up to my FFL 3 weeks later. This action, this very one, I've been running my entire PRS career. They just take care of people. It's hard to find a company with as good as people as they have. the actions kind of speak for themselves. You could probably look at this field of shooters, which is arguably the toughest field of shooters in the country, if not the world. Probably 70% of the actions out here would be defiance or actions made by defiance under a different name. They just work. DefianceMachine.com. Call up there and you can ask for Mike Lee himself.
Yep.
He'll answer the phone and answer any question you have. If you can't, he'll get an answer.
Hi, my name's Jim C. I shoot for Team Surgeon Rifles, and we're here at the 2015 PRS Finale Match. Surgeon Rifles was gracious enough to donate this finished and complete rifle for the prize table. Jay Allen donated the stock, and US Optics donated the rifle scope. Surgeon put this together in their shop in Phoenix, Arizona, and it will be one of the prizes on the table. Our parent company, Strategic Armory Corp., also owns Armalite Rifles, who have donated a prize package rifle for this match, as well as Nexus Ammunition is another one of our companies that will be launching a new line of ammunition for professional shooters this year.
Stage 12, tubes. With a possibility of 10 points, there are 7 targets with a 90-second time limit. On the left, there's 12-inch squares shot from the left tube, and on the right, there's a rack shot from the right tube. All shots must pass through the tube. With a 10-round maximum, only one shot per target.
I was about to fall out the front of that thing.
I hit the wood on the first two.
Yeah, I think you hit the wood. We had another shooter who was shooting the wood.
In the wood?
Just make sure you're safe with that muzzle. Yeah, don't shoot the wood. See a little Swiss cheese action on that wood?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Can we brass out before we get in? I mean, so I don't put my knee on a piece of brass.
Okay, fine. Just make that request before you get in there. I'll be going after the comedy.
We're here with Ryan Kerr, who just ran the tubes, stage 12 of day 2. How was it for you?
It turned out pretty well for me. Dropped one shot rushing things. Thought I was going to time out, jerk the trigger a little bit. But otherwise, wind calls were pretty solid and things felt pretty good.
Drop that one.
Yeah. Are the winds a little bit nicer to you today versus yesterday?
Definitely. A little bit more consistent today. Still a little bit of wind, just enough to mess you up. But a little bit more consistent where we can actually get some corrections.
Seems like everyone's having a great time down there. Seems like you guys are having a great time up here. It's a beautiful day.
Definitely. Beautiful day, beautiful country. Couldn't ask for nicer weather. A little bit of breeze to keep it cool and to push our shots around a little bit. Got to keep it interesting.
Impact!
All right, Matt, we just finished our speed trial, our tiebreaker here. How do you feel you did?
I did fairly well. The wind was a little tricky. Kept on switching from about 3 o'clock to about 1 o'clock, so it's a little difficult to keep up with. But overall, it was an awesome stage. Keeps you moving, new position for every 2 rounds. It's just up to the shooter to see how smooth they can run it and not jump the gun and slap the trigger.
This morning, you guys were on the top half of the course here. You're on the bottom half today. How'd the top treat you?
The top did pretty well. Wind started picking up about an hour into our shooting, but I think we all did pretty well, pretty consistent, and the mountain hasn't gotten the best of us yet.
Team Marksman International, how do you guys think you're performing in relation to all the other teams that are out here? Very competitive right now.
It is very competitive, and you know it's you got to push yourself. Remember, you're out here with the top 100 shooters in the country, so. Coming in anywhere in that group is a great thing. I hope to all of us finish top 25%, and I think we're fighting hard to get there, but winds are tricky out here, so it's all that we can do to keep up with it.
Impact! Impact!
So in case there is a tie, we have World War Z, stage 17, set up as the tiebreaker. The scoring here is pretty simple. You have two targets, 90-second time limit, and unlimited rounds. Only two rounds may be fired from each shooting port, one round on each target. The muzzle must extend through each shooting port while firing. If there is a match scoring tie, the highest score on this stage will be used to break that tie. If the tied shooters have the same score on this stage, the fastest time will be used to break that tie.
We're here at day two of the PRS 2015 championship, and I'm with rookie contender and law enforcement contender for a title here. And this is Mr. John Griswold. How are you doing, sir?
Not too bad.
Awesome. How does it feel to be a rookie of the year and top law enforcement contender?
Being a contender is great at all these matches. You know, it isn't over yet. It's great anytime you can finish in top end with crowds like this. I mean, it's always an honor because there is some very talented shooters at every location.
What made you decide to join PRS?
The competition is a different level. I mean, I shot a lot of different matches before. This is where the big boys go to shoot. And if you want to test your skills and your skill level, I mean, this is the game.
Absolutely. So how does this play into your professional life as law enforcement?
It definitely is my hobby. I mean, obviously in law enforcement, we carry guns, but hopefully we don't have to use them and take my mind off work and enjoy it with some great people.
So since you're you're in contention for Rookie of the Year, what would you say to our viewers if they wanted to join PRS? What would be the one piece or two pieces of advice that you could give us?
Number one is you gotta go. I mean, you aren't gonna get better. You aren't gonna learn much out on your own until you come see how the game is played. You know, if you don't feel comfortable going for your first match and shooting, then come RO a match. We'll look at the guy's gear, see what they're using, talk to them. If you go up and talk to them, I mean, they're going to tell you anything you want to know. There's nothing hidden here. There's no secrets, because that's what we're trying to do, is grow the sport. A lot of people interested. Obviously, it is grown, so people are doing a good job, but just go. Go attend one. Have fun.
Hi, I'm Jared Joplin with American Precision Arms. We are the muzzle brake sponsor for this event. We make a multitude of different items. We've been a custom gun builder now for almost two decades, and we released this muzzle brake design almost a decade ago, and since then it has really become popular, and it's the main muzzle brake being used in the PRS right now and the most effective design that we know of. We're here to compete and have a good time. We wish the best to all the people that made it out here. It's been a long, tough road for everybody to get here. We're probably about glad that it's over, but we wish everybody the best and look forward to seeing you out on the range.
Hi, this is George Gardner at the Precision Rifle Series 2015 Finals. This is the first match that we've shot a production Tempest action. This is our new action that we debuted here this year. It's a three-lug action. It's really fast. It's been a pleasure to shoot. It's probably 50% faster than the old two-lug action as far as being able to stroke the bolt. It kind of allows you to shoot the speed drills a little bit better, get back on your gun a little bit faster on the getting back on the target. We're really proud of it, and we're glad to bring it here. I'd like to wish all the 2015 finalists a great match, and see you guys at the finish line. If anyone interested in GA Precision Rifles, please contact us on Facebook or gaprecision.net.
Best Targets, trophy supplier to the 2015 PRS National Championship, manufactures the best engineered, highest quality AR-500 steel target systems for the shooting sports industry. Our lineup includes 3/8-inch and 1/2-inch thick precision rifle targets of all shapes and sizes, as well as the Last Stands target stands and hangers in our Best Targets flasher kit. Best Targets target stands and 3/8-inch thick static steel targets are suitable for pistol use. The post-op target system is designed for USPSA scoring and three-gun competition. The six-plate target rack Our flagship item can be used indoors and outdoors for individual practice or head-to-head competition. Look for us online at www.bestdealtargets.com. Check out our Best Targets Facebook page or talk to one of our Best Targets team shooters at an event near you.
All right, folks, this is it. It's the very last course of fire for the 2015 PRS Championships. Let's go ahead and move over to Stage 20 and check out how the top 10 shooters are doing. Stage 20 is called the shoot move. Shoot some more. There's a possibility of 8 points, 4 targets, and a 90-second time limit. All targets must hit impact before moving to the next group. Basically, we're going to be shooting cross-canyon targets, which must be engaged from shooting area 1. The diamond may only be engaged from shooting area 2.
Bye. I had a rough morning. I shot pretty well yesterday, had a rough morning, and then I picked it up this afternoon. So I did okay, but not as well as I would have liked. We're in squad 1. We're the top 10 coming into this, and this entire match we've been sharing wind calls, equipment, gear, info, little things. I mean, so the, as competitive as it gets, you don't lose that friendship.
Oh, the season was challenging. A lot of great shooters out here. You know, you got to be on the ball every single match, and you know, any one of them's able to win the match.
Today, coming into this match, or this weekend coming into this match, you're seeded number 1. You're favored to take the win. All of your teammates over here think you took the win. What do you think?
As far as the series goes, I think I got it. But as far as the match goes, you know, there's too many other good shooters out there in the other squads that, you know, any one of them could have won it. So we'll wait and see.
I don't get stressed out with the shooting. I just shoot to have fun and get better. My whole goal is to shoot to my potential and get better every season. Dave Preston, I mean, he's my hero. We made a pact last year to go 1-2, and you know, I just want to stay right there with him and us kind of, you know, pave the way to get better and better every year.
You know, I had my first two stages this afternoon were great. I got 7 out of 8, and then I got a high score for 11, which is the tiebreaker stage, so I was really proud of that. And then I cleaned the next stage, and then I dropped 2 points on the last two stages. And so, you know, when you get in this kind of competition, when you start dropping points like that, people start sliding by you, and that's just how this game goes. But overall, I'm happy with my performance. You know, there's just a lot of points out here to get, and so if you drop any points, you kind of fall behind the eight ball. You know, I just want to thank all the guys I shot with. Everyone was just really awesome this weekend.
I had a good yesterday, I had a good morning. This afternoon I had one bad stage. It probably put me back a few places. I'm pretty confident I placed in the top 10 for this series and probably for this match. So I started this in 2012, been shooting for 4 years in the PRS series, and the talent has just exponentially improved. I mean, Kevin is an example. This was his first year shooting the PRS series, and he actually finished in the top 10. It's great for the sport, getting the new guys in and you know, keeping us old guys on our toes.
The end of the competition has arrived and the award ceremony is about to begin. We want to give a very special thanks to all of the ROs and sponsors that made this weekend a possibility. This has been a blast and we can't wait until next season begins.
Now rounded up most of you guys.
Run us through with a count.
Well, that's one of these done. Three good stage at least. I think we have more than that.
Personally, from my experience, you guys are the best crew I've ever seen.
That's why we've donated cash to the awards, and we've got bullets on the prize table, because you guys have overwhelmingly said that you wanted to shoot our bullets, and we're happy to support and be here for you guys.
I can't tell you how proud we are to sponsor the PRS series as a whole. You guys put on a show this weekend.
Hope you guys enjoyed the beer. Hope you enjoyed the mugs. Please take those home. And hey!
It's been an honor shooting with you guys. We look forward to seeing you guys next year.
We'll continue to sponsor as many matches as we can. Thanks.
We got with Euro Optic, we got with Mile High, and we got with Knife Force, and what we have is a an AX short action multi-caliber system.
Top senior Tim, we got a gift certificate from OTM Tactical, and thousands from Butch's.
Thank you.
also an OTM Tactical 250 off. And I think it's back there. Yep. We got 1,000 cash. All right, fifth place, Jeremy Bentham. Come on up. Fourth place, last year's champion, Brian Morgan. Third place, Jake, come on up. Third place, overall points. Second place, Mr. Second himself all year long, Joe Walls. And the big golden bullet, $5,000 winner.
My hero.
DP, Dave Preston, come on up.
So how do you feel after winning the championship?
Oh, it's kind of a relief. You know, you put in hours and hours of practice and, you know, long nights shooting, and it's finally paid off, so I'm pretty happy.
All right, Dave, so I don't know if you know this or not, but it hasn't been since 2012 that the season champion and the match champion have been one and the same.
You know, coming into this, you know, with 20, 30, the top guys in the country, any one of them is perfectly capable of winning the match. So to be able to win the match and win the points race is just, you know, I don't really have words for it right now.
I'm sure you're a little bit overwhelmed. You've been in the spotlight all night. You know, you've done a phenomenal job. I'm not going to keep you any longer. We truly appreciate all your support and look forward to watching you perform next year.
Sounds good. Thank you.
Awesome. Thank you.
Congratulations.
The 2015 Precision Rifle Series Championship has finally come to an end. We want to thank all of our sponsors, ROs, staff members, and especially our competitors, wishing them the best of luck in the 2016 season and beyond.